What is up guys, how are you all doing? Welcome back to yet another interesting video, or rather I would say this will be a useful video for you guys, because in this video I'll be looking at some important privacy settings that you need to change on your mobile phone right now. Because as you guys know, these days data is really important. It's getting very very important for a lot of things that we don't even come across, but the companies require those data to like access everything that you have got. So they try to understand what you're trying to do, what the consumers want, and how they can target based on the like political things, be it or be it for the consumer related things, right? So let's not go deeper into that. The thing is, you have got some control on your mobile phone that you can change, and that's what I'm going to show you in this video. I'll share you 5 important security tips that you need to change it on your mobile phone right now. Also guys, like you may be aware of whatever apps that you are using, with or without conscious, you might have just tapped on that allow access to storage media or allow access to camera or rather any stuff like that. But once you tap on that allow button, the companies can literally access your data, your personal stuff, your personal photos, and they can misuse it as well. So we just don't know what they are trying to do with that, right? So how to avoid that? So that's what I'm going to show you in this video. So before we begin this video, if you like these kind of videos, give this video a thumbs up and don't forget to click on that subscribe button if you are new to my channel. Alright guys, then let's look at those important settings that you need to change. The first thing you want to do is to like go to Google settings over here inside your mobile settings. The first thing is to turn off this ads personalization, right? Because if you just opt to the ads personalization, whatever data I've got, depending on that, it keeps recommending you the advertisements, right? Which you don't want to do it because it accesses your data. So I have turned this off. Make sure you do that as well. That's the first thing. So the second important thing is to go to manage your Google account over here. Just tap on this one. Here you'll find data and personalization. This is where everything gets interesting. As you can see, activity control, pretty much whatever you do on your mobile phone will be shown up here. So whatever you search, whatever you browse, whatever activity you do with the apps, everything that you do on your phone can be viewed over here, right? So depending on your preference, you can customize these things. But the thing is, what I'm trying to say is, just go to this web and app activity. You can turn this on or entirely turn this off. So again, depends on your preference. But the thing is, make sure you don't tick these things, right? As you can see, I've turned this off, these two check boxes. So one is the Chrome history and activity from sites, apps and devices, which you don't want to turn it on. And there is also audio recording, because whenever you say, okay, Google, and use the audio function, it records stuff, right? It may be for your better thing, because Google recommends better things based on what your input is. But the thing is, we just don't want them to give those access. So that is why you just disable this one. Also, there is auto delete, turn it off, and there is manage activity here. Again, if you go over here, there are so many things that you can customize. So make sure, as you can see, whatever you do on your mobile phone can be literally viewed here, right? So if you don't want this to happen, make sure you turn this off. Also, just you can see location history, which is paused. Also, YouTube history can be paused. Similarly, you just tap on manage your activity controls and make sure that you do that for all the other rest of the things as well. So again, that's really important. The next one is here inside the security. Again, there is two-step verification which you want to do it. So make sure you tap on this one and make sure this is turned on. Make sure your account has two-step verification all the time. Again, there are app passwords. So if you have saved on your account, you can view it over here. There are devices, your devices. So make sure you know the devices that are using your account. Otherwise, if you find any suspicious account over here, or mobile phones or any other devices, make sure to tap on that and remove access, right? This is again really important. Like this can show you whoever is hacking your phone without your knowing. So that's again an important thing over here. Also, people and sharing, what you're sharing with your friends or pretty much anybody over here, that you can also see it over here. So make sure you do it accordingly. So guys, another important thing is, inside the settings, there is always this privacy thing. Which is like here, privacy, which is also a permission manager. So if you go over here, make sure you turn these two off. Send diagnostic data and receive marketing information, we don't want that. Also, if you tap on permission manager, this is like literally going to apps section and accessing the permission manager. You can do that as well on your phone. Now here, like what apps are using these functions? Let's say you have some apps that are accessing camera without your permission. So you can view it over here. Let's say we don't want this B612 to access my camera. So you can just go ahead and tap on deny. So again, depending on your preference, you can set this one. Let's say this Interphoto, this need not access my camera, right? So what I do is to tap on deny. So this is what you want to do with all those apps that you have like suspicious or you just don't use it often. See, PowerPoint doesn't require camera access, so you can just go ahead and deny that. So this is the thing you want to do with your mobile phone as well. Make sure the apps that you are not using are denied there. Denied access of permission, right? Similarly with the storage, SMS, physical activity, you can literally see over here how many apps are accessing what all the things from your mobile phone. So this is again very important that you need to change. So guys, there are actually so many things that I can show up over here to change inside settings. But the thing is, these were really important. Make sure you do that as well. And let me know in the comment section down below if you've got any questions, and secure your mobile phone right now. All right, guys, if you like these kind of videos, hit that like button and don't forget to click on that subscribe button if you are new to my channel. I will see you all in another one. Till then, take care, everyone. Bye bye.